Hey everyone, welcome back. I hope you enjoyed last week's video. It was certainly a lot of fun to make. Very different to what I'm usually doing, but I had a lot of fun with Simon talking about how we recommend books whilst also trying to do something else, which really did not work. We might return to that stunt another time. I might try and give books away to strange people in the street when I've got a bit more time, certainly. I'll put a link to that video if you didn't see it last week. As I say, it was a lot of fun. But this week, I am back to talking about books. Last week, or the week before last week, I was talking about The Association of Small Bombs by Karen Mahajan. Fantastic book. I had two copies to give away, and the lucky people winning those copies are Joe Reed and Draw Your Book. Congratulations, both of you. You will find my email address at the bottom of this video's description. Send me your postal addresses, and I'll get copies off to you as soon as I can. This week, it is a return to the 2016 Classics Challenge. If you don't know what that is, bloggers and vloggers over Twitter and YouTube are sort of committing themselves to reviewing a classic every month of the year. And I've been joining in too. If you search that tag on YouTube, go through the vlog videos, you'll see it in the description. You can see the different types of classics I've been reading and talking about. There's lots of brilliant books to discover out there, obviously. So do have a search on Twitter if you want to find more. And this week, I'm reading one which is sort of influenced by one of my previous reads. So if you look back, and I'll put a link here, I reviewed a book called Black Boy by Richard Wright, which is a fantastic book, all about his upbringing, his young life in Prohibition-era America as a black man, or as a black child, really, and then a young man. And no other book I've read has made so painfully clear what it actually would feel like to grow up as a minority in that era, and to have that constant fear and to live with prejudice every day of your life and to feel culturally isolated from the country in which you live to the point where you feel your body shaking every time you leave the house. It's an amazing book, so I do recommend that. But I wanted to sort of enrich my reading even further, and I think partly because of some recent events in America, you would have seen the hashtag Black Lives Matter all over Twitter. There have been many shootings by police on black men and women, killings all over the place, retaliatory shootings at American police. It's just an awful, awful situation. And my suspicion has always been that the best way to understand the contemporary, to understand what's happening now, is to go back into history and to understand a little bit more about what has brought us to this point. Context is everything, especially with very difficult and complex issues like that. You need to understand where it started, why it's perpetuated, and why it continues for many years into the future. So I wanted to go back a little bit further. And we published a book called The Narrative of the Life of Frederick Douglass, an American Slave. And this is an absolute sort of classic. I mean, it's a historical text almost. Frederick Douglass was born a slave and lived a slave until he eventually escaped. And he then went on to become a very famous speaker about the idea of abolition. And this was published in 1845, and the abolition of slavery happened in 1865. And so therefore, again, another what I'm going to call an important book. It's a text almost. And I wanted to read it because I wanted to better understand that era. I'm going away from sort of an era of prejudice, but one into outright slavery. And it's sort of difficult to know what to say about this book, really. As you can see, it's quite a slim book, but it is as powerful and visceral as a recent film like 12 Years a Slave, for example. Straight away, you are into this world where people are treated worse than animals, subjected to violence and fear and intimidation on a daily basis, living in constant hunger and poverty, just having no control over their lives in many ways. Although I say that, and then there's this extraordinary bit where he talks about the holidays and how you would think that those moments in which you don't have to work all hours of the day might be a great release. But in fact, he suspects that what happens is that the slave owners encourage their slaves to drink to excess on those holidays so that they get absolutely wasted and do terrible things and realize, or feel rather, that without the control of their masters, life outside of slavery is just an uncontrolled mess of debauchery and illness and all sorts of stuff. So that it seems almost safer after those 2 or 3 days of sort of mad behaviour to then get back to the sort of rigid routine and discipline of being a slave, working in the fields or wherever it might be, and being sort of cared for by your master. that just the whole language of master and slave in this book is just, after a while, you just realise how damaging that is and how that enforces this relationship. There's amazing spirit, of course, in him as a person. There's an incredible bit where he realises that he's not going to stand for it anymore, and that, in fact, when he asserts his strength as a man over one of his masters, and he challenges him physically, it's an incredible bit of the book, because you would think that that would just endanger your life, and indeed it is for many slaves. You know, any hint of sort of challenge to the master would mean you'd just be killed, and they would sort of worry about how to sort that out at a later date. But he is just not going to take it anymore, and so he challenges his master. And luckily, this particular slave master, his pride is that he can break any slave. And so he knows that he cannot sort of send Frederick off to be hung in public, because it would be an admission of his own weakness, that he hadn't been able to break this slave. So in fact, he doesn't retaliate physically. He has to find another way of dealing with him, or indeed of getting rid of him. So there are just so many extraordinary set pieces in this book as you go through his life. A failed escape attempt just before the end, which is sort of heartbreaking. You just feel like he's going to make his break for it, and then he's back where he began. But as I say, just this sort of crushing, painful awfulness throughout his childhood, especially, so complex. He was born a slave. His mother was a slave, and it is suspected that his father was a master. And there's this very weird relationship that then happens, because any kind of special treatment that you might get from that master means that you're resented, of course, by the rest of the group. So he was always in a very, very difficult situation from birth onwards. And of course, a great joy and relief when he finally does escape, and knowing that he went on to write this incredibly important testimony to his life. And I feel that it has indeed enriched my understanding of that era. And now I feel better equipped to kind of move forward again and to read other books in this sort of area. So there we go. The Narrative of the Life of Frederick Douglass, an American Slave, is another vintage classic. I will again have two copies to give away. However, I'm going on holiday. Sorry. 2 weeks I'm going to be away, so there will be no vlog for 2 weeks, and then I'll come back the following week to announce the winners of this particular book. What will I be talking about when I come back from holiday? Who knows? Because I'm taking pretty much an entire suitcase full of books, no clothes. I'm just going to read as much as I can and come back and tell you all about it. Actually, I can tell you that my first video when I come back will probably be a vintage-free zone. I'll be talking about non-vintage books that I have been reading this year and that I haven't had a chance to tell you about. So, yeah, there you go. If you want to hear a little bit more about some of the other stuff that I've been reading, that will be a good video to watch. Have a good few weeks without me, and I'll see you in a few weeks' time. Take care.